Welcome to IPA with a CPA. We're here to share ideas to help you and your business make more money and keep more of the money you make. Hi, I'm Paul Mueller.
And I'm Robin Pye. Paul and I are CPAs and owners of Mueller Pye & Associates with offices in Northern Colorado and Katy, Texas.
Today's topic is about retirement plans, which is a big consideration for a lot of companies.
Definitely. Yeah, but first let's talk about the beer.
Yeah, all so right. We're at Verboten Brewery in historic downtown Loveland, and the beer we have in front of us is You Can't Handle the Passion Fruit.
All right.
Want to give
it
a try?
Let's give it a taste, yeah.
Okay.
Cheers.
Yeah.
Really fruity.
Yep.
I like that.
Mm-hmm.
That's good. So, you know, one thing I'm passionate about is retirement planning.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. Because, so with retirement planning, it's one of the best tax deductions that you can get, and you're paying yourself.
Right.
So you're saving tax dollars and putting money in your own pocket.
It's still your money.
It's still your money.
That's right.
So reducing your tax bill, saving your own money, mm-hmm. Doesn't get much better than that.
That's for sure.
But there are a lot of decisions that go into retirement planning. Mm-hmm. What type of plan are you going to have?
And we'll talk about that because there's two different types.
There's two different types. Mm-hmm. Who are you going to cover?
Right.
When are you going to start coverage? Mm-hmm. And who's going to manage the investments?
Yeah.
So lots of different decisions to be made. Lots of motivations for people to do retirement planning.
What do you hear from your clients? Why do they do retirement plans?
So for the tax deduction,
mm-hmm.
I think that's where the benefit is today.
Yeah.
But the future benefit that you're saving, for down the road,
mm-hmm.
To also attract and retain and motivate employees.
Yeah.
You've got to be competitive in the marketplace.
And why is that?
Because everybody's doing it,
yeah.
And there's a limited talent pool, and so you want to retain the best employees.
It's almost like if you don't offer a 401k, prospective employees wonder what's wrong with you.
Yeah, yeah. Exactly. You've got to be competitive in that market. So walk us through the different types of plans.
Okay, so there's lots of plans, lots of different names for plans,
yep.
But they really boil down to two types of plans. The first one is defined contribution plan. And it's exactly what it says. The law defines how much you can contribute to the plan.
Okay.
So it's usually a percentage of earnings, or it's some kind of a dollar cap. It's like, you know, you can only put $5,500 into an IRA, or you can only put 25% of your pay into a retirement plan. The law specifies how much you can contribute to the plan. Contrast that with the second type of plan, which is a defined benefit plan. And those used to be really popular in the 60s and 70s, not quite so much as popular as they used to be.
Yeah, we don't see them much anymore.
We don't see them, but I think we're going to see them starting to come back as the workforce, particularly owners, age. These types of plans become a lot more attractive.
Okay.
So a defined contribution plan to make it different, defined contribution plan tells you how much you can put in. A defined benefit plan tells you how much you can pull out at retirement. So through some actuarial calculations, mortality tables, rates of return, those types of assumptions, an actuary can tell you how much do you have to put in today to have this pot of gold in the future to pay out that retirement.
So a defined contribution plan, you're going to have a lot more flexibility. With a defined benefit plan, you have to contribute a certain amount to get those future returns.
You're locked in. And that's why a lot of companies don't like to get into those plans, because once you get in, it's hard to get out.
And a defined contribution plan, you can contribute or you can choose not to contribute, correct?
Yeah.
Okay.
Right. Yeah, so you have that kind of flexibility. A lot of flexibility.
Okay.
So again, defined benefit plans have been out of favor, but they can be very valuable because based on those actuarial calculations, you can come up with some huge contributions that are totally deductible that you could never get close to with a defined contribution plan.
Okay.
Now, on the flip side of that, there is a lot of administrative work that goes into it because you have to have an actuary do all this work. You got to do these calculations. So the administrative fees and the actuarial costs can sometimes be pretty expensive and put people off.
Okay. What about reporting and record keeping? Tax reporting?
So most plans are going to have to file what's called a 5500 with the Department of Labor and the IRS. And that gets pretty complicated, particularly if the plans get large enough. You even have to get audits.
Wow.
Financial statement audit for certain retirement plans. That can be very costly. Yeah.
Okay, all right. Yeah. And then you've got a budget for those. You know, if you have a 401k plan and you've got a safe harbor or you're doing a matching, you've got to budget for those contributions.
Yeah.
So that's important to remember.
And you know, you have to weigh how much are you putting in for the employees versus how much are the owners putting into the plan.
Right.
And you know, my basic yardstick is if 80% or more of the dollars aren't going to the owner.
Okay.
I typically don't recommend a retirement plan because the owner could hold on to all the money, pay the tax, and probably walk away with more money.
Sure.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Well, this has been great.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Robin and I hope you found this information useful. Be sure to send us an email with any comments, questions, or suggestions for future topics.
And be sure to check back on our YouTube channel for the next IPA with a CPA. Until next time,
Prost.